Yo, what is up, YouTube? Welcome back to my channel. Welcome back to this Sunday episode. This is a raw episode of all the moments we've experienced over the past couple weeks, all condensed into an episode for a Sunday episode. Hope you guys enjoy this. And sorry in advance, there's a lot of like up and down on the sound. It's something that we're gonna work on and try to make sure going forward. Everything will be on point, from the audio to the visuals. Our goal is to try to give you guys as much value and as much insight into what it takes to build a small independent brand into something great. And that's kind of our goal for this brand is to take something that, you know, an idea and blow it up and try to grow it in the most organic, way. Into something that's big and meaningful. Thank you guys for tuning in into this channel. Feel free to like this video. I'll leave any comments about anything, any questions or anything like that. We'll try to make episodes for them. Subscribe to this channel and hope you enjoy this episode.
This man frustrated.
He's gonna sell shit.
A template.
Bro, today felt nice. I kind of like the rain.
Bro, that shit was shitty, bro.
Rain is...
That shit thick as fuck, bro. I ain't gonna lie. That motherfucker got me through winter last year in Milwaukee. Another thing, bro. I'm lucky, like, when I get back to Milwaukee, I'm gonna be fucking cold.
I don't.
Look at my desktop.
I didn't even see it yet.
Why?
What the fuck's going on?
What is this? Is this because you haven't restarted it in over a year?
Nah, that's not why, bro.
Danish has been. Oh my god.
Wow. The universe is like.
Did you
nope.
Turn it off,
dude,
bro.
I'm definitely getting. Someone's fucking with me right now.
Turn
someone
it off.
Up there is just like.
Turn it off, bro.
Let me just fuck up with.
Get a hard restart it.
What happened leading up to this?
Dude, I'm stressing about this production shit, bro. And it's just...
What the fuck? Dude, I'll still restart it. Now I'll see if I got it.
Oh my god.
Just scratch disc. It's a cool visual, though. Like, the audio things.
This week's just been kind of shit. Come on, the heater isn't working. Like,
the universe is testing
work
sure,
right
bro.
Now, bro.
Michael got bit by a mosquito. He's turning into Mosquito Man.
I did.
Should it not work?
The heater? Are we gonna take this back to the where we got it?
I have to. Too much shit to get done. Manufacturer's not gonna get it done in time. We're on our own timeline. And this is the life of DIY. what our pop-ups always are. They're not like always unorganized.
Back out here on the strip. The hustle for Complex Con. Getting some pieces produced. Sourcing the week before. In grand style of Unfinished Legacy.
One week.
Finding new resources always, finding new plugs. It's always a vibe.
What made you get the machine?
Yeah, we tried it for a while, and everybody down the street was giving me issues already with the whole price and the whole turnaround time. So I was like, man, I got my bag ready. And I just,
get that shit done yourself.
It's your USB right here, right?
Yeah. Service fiber optic internet for just $74.99 per month, plus a Visa reward card on top.
Gotta get a DTD machine in here.
Yeah, but that'll get you some fast money.
We still do the DTG work. We have our boy. We just don't have the machine in here. But yeah, we got to get it in. We also have everything here.
You got big space.
Yeah, I got space for it, man.
And what colors you guys want on the background? Or the butterfly?
The butterfly is white.
So blanco?
So, yeah. White and then
azul. Azul.
What like, do you want? Like the royal blue or the navy
the
blue?
The royal. That's the outline, right? It's good. Few hours trying to get shit done. Sometimes it doesn't go as planned. Just gotta keep a level head and stick to the plan. And deal with the obstacles.
So much obstacles.
What would you do different this week? If you could like go back and like plan it differently or?
It's not even me. It's not plan or anything. Dude, the heater not working, that has nothing, like, that, I can't control that. Yeah. The bank won't let me withdraw money, like, bro, we got money in the bank account, like, why can't we, like...
Like, when his son wasn't with him, he would show them, he'd be like, this is my son, he's my light of my life.
It turns out that you want to change
the partner.
Yeah, Alvaro. No, you're my left. Alvaro, nice to meet you. Alvaro, Jane, nice to meet you. Nice to meet you.
Yeah, start to finish, a lot of them have pre-sale, so they, you know, they sell everything online, we make it in different forms, so you can see things, A-frame, embroidery, woven labels, full packing, PVC, whatever you can
do. You guys don't do fulfillment though?
We do fulfillment, yeah. Right. Yeah, so that one brand I mentioned, we'll make samples, they'll put it up online, and then sell a shit ton of it, and then we'll be ready to make it, so. Typically like 2 weeks, 3 weeks, we'll get it out, make everything. Literally printing money, it's crazy.
Oh, yeah.
You know, what's up, money man? Merch. Money merch, yeah, exactly. Yeah,
yeah, and it's just like cool with the lights and everything else. Yeah, we got a bunch of samples.
Whoa. Can we show these off?
Yeah.
Dude, this is crazy.
What up, you out?
Yeah.
See you, bro.
We can get taller. The taller you get, the worse it washes off. So we have like a. If you're going to shops that have big ass puff, it would be crazy. It's like, bro, you're going to wash that, it's going to crack. there's no real way to like cure it 100%, but the more times you cure it, the harder it is to wash out, the longer it's going to last.
Screen print.
Yeah, screen. What's the process called, though?
Simulated process.
Simulated. Damn, this is crazy.
Sheesh. Yeah, it's hard.
Yeah, we're doing those overseas. We don't do those here. Those go crazy.
We did a couple of drops for him.
For him.
And the stars on this one glow in the dark.
Snaps.
Screen printed.
That was fire.
He said the stars glow in the dark. Was that, the client asked for that, or you just like...
No, that was them, yeah.
Okay, for sure.
We got some glow in the dark in here.
Just trying to see how far it can stretch the possibilities,
yeah.
You know?
For sure, yeah. Yeah, that way you gotta take it one step up, you know?
Oh, yeah.
Water. It's
watercolor.
Damn.
Crazy, right?
Yeah, it's just... Is it water ink? Water-based?
No, this is, this is pasta.
It's like in there.
Yeah, it's just because of...
Mesh.
Yeah, the mesh is really high, so you're not putting as much ink down.
Okay.
And it's on a white. You know, if we print on this black, it'd be way heavier.
Yeah.
So we knew everybody. And, I kind of just would show up and just, all right, what do you need, bro? Like, what can I do? And I wouldn't leave. I'd come in there. And I'd broker jobs here and there, make some money. He would charge me one price. I'd charge another. But I literally would just show up and just learn game. He wouldn't even be there sometimes. I was like, all right, what do you guys need help with just to learn? You know, and I did that for 2 years. Kind of part-time. I would go ahead and make a job, too. And he was doing, you know, this is back in, like, 2010, 2011. He was doing fulfillment. He was doing importing from China. No one was really doing that at the time, but he came from the band background. You know, we were doing big, like, As They Lay Dying, like, LMFAO at the time. It was crazy. And just, like, to see, it's like, dude, LMFAO was...
Yeah, they were nuts, fucking bro. It, bro. Yeah.
Just soaked up game, and then I kind of, like, broke off and did my own thing. Started with the manual and just worked my way up. But seeing how he did it, and he offered everything in one spot, and that was kind of like, cool, I want to be the one-stop shop instead of you going to me for embroidery, but then you're going down the street for screen print. And that's really, like... done well for us. It's like, what do you need? We just got a sticker printer. Now we are going to do stickers. So it's like, fuck, what else? You know?
Yeah.
Cut and sell? Maybe? I don't know, man. It's like I battle my mind every day. Like, should I do that? It's like a whole other world.
Yeah.
I know we would kill it. It just, I don't know if I have the energy to, like, learn the process, finding the people and all that. So. But, yeah, here's our current setup. We got three machines. We got 2 14 colors and a 6 color. Next door, we're adding 2 more. I need to adjust it, but put it on there. Make sure it's even both sides. There's a little sensor back here. So we just gotta adjust it so that way it, you know,
yeah, gets right back over and shit.
So this is your bag here. You got a little flow. Drop it in here.
That sealed
it. That means it, yeah. Fire. Fire.
That's crazy. No, we do direct the screen, so this prints the image on the screen with wax.
Wait, what?
Oh, okay.
Yeah.
And it comes off?
They don't burn it, it's straight.
We burn it, but it's a different process. But with the film, there's
the transparency, right? No transparency.
Yeah, there's you get a lot of pinholes. There's a lot of accuracy issues trying to line it up on the screen. The same way this puts it on the screen, in the same exact spot every single time. The lines are crispier. It's just better. Everything's better. That is faster. Registration's faster.
Wow.
good?
Sam.
Do I need to adjust this?
One second.
Someone's like a different world. He's like, this is how pros do it.
Well,
yeah.
Like a far shot.
So this is going to evenly burn it with a light table. Yeah, so that's water right there. And he's got a nice flow, so he can kind of do everything. He's got a nice little system going.
Oh, yeah. Could already have another one here.
Exactly,
going back and forth.
Yeah.
That's just storage for the coders?
That
things?
Is the cleaner.
Oh,
so
okay,
we don't
okay.
clean anything manually. So we have three chambers. This is a pressure washer. Excuse me. This is ink remover.
Okay.
This is emulsion remover. And then this is a pressure washer. So you put it in a screen. We take all the ink off.
Oh, it goes inside.
It goes inside, yeah.
What the fuck?
We take all the ink off the screen. It feeds in here when it's on. Goes in here.
It's the text.
And then each chamber. So this is isolated. So this is ink remover.
Yeah,
so this has bristles and it scrubs the ink off. This is emulsion remover, so all the ink's off, comes in here. All your emulsion sprays
see
it.
See all the residue, yeah.
Yep. We could clean like 50 screens, 8 hours, depending, you know, what it is. Now, this can do about 200 to 300 a day. So now he's not cleaning screens every day. He's maintaining the machine. He's doing other things. But again, the automation, we're able to train new people. Before, it's like, fuck, I've been doing this for 10 years. I know how to do it the perfect way. Now, it's just like, you know how to turn a button on. All the storage all coded, ready to use. So we kind of we have it organized by mesh count.
Fire.
So right now he's probably gonna be working on whatever's here because we're out completely. 110. So it's kind of all organized. So we have like, kind of dehumidifier in here, so it takes all the moisture out of the air and they dry really quick.
Yeah. Quick turn. Super organized.
Quick turnaround. We do what we say, and a lot of people in the industry don't. You know, they'll say I'll have it tomorrow, and it's really next week, and. A lot of people don't like to have the conversation. I'd rather have the conversation up front. And it's really, people really fuck with that. And a lot of people don't do that. A lot.
It helps the relationship.
Especially
if you can't trust, you know, we can't trust your words.
You're going and communicating to your followers,
exactly.
Hey, it's going to be ready this day. It's like, you know, I know this conversation is hard, but reality, it's going to be done next week. But when I say that, it's done next week.
Communication is the biggest thing.
So, that.
What's, like when you're hand printing shit like Brema, you know, until like now you got this beautiful facility, everything's automatic. What's maybe like one or two of the biggest things you've learned in that, like getting here?
What's the biggest thing I learned? You learn a lot, bro. You learn finance, you learn legal,
mental state,
mental, personal, everything. You know, the hardest thing is probably people maintaining a good team and the morale within the team. And you know, everyone's got their own issues, so having to put the way you feel aside and, you know, making sure everybody's happy to work here. And it's very hard navigating, you know, many people. We're about 30 people now, total.
Nice.
So, dealing with all that and keeping people happy and people come and people go. It's awesome, though, man.
Oh, yeah. Appreciate that.
I didn't know this when I started. You learn as you go.
Exactly.
You know, figure it out. Do a mistake, you know, try to make the mistake only the mistake one time and not multiple times, and that's how you grow.
That's Supreme Access. That's a Supreme Premium Access.
I could have parked it.
Wanna say where we're at and stuff?
Ah, this shit's loud as fuck.
Where are you? Good. Come on in.
This island is crazy, bro.
Yeah, this is awesome.
This is Randy.
Your brother.
That's my brother. That's all him right there. That's all hand painted right there.
That's fine, man.
Yeah. Welcome to film if you want anything. That's cool with me. That's cool. Sorry, I'm just in the middle of printing. I want to make sure that I get the.
That's fine. Do
what you gotta do, man. Work first.
We mostly focus a lot. Let me turn that off real quick because I was sweating, man.
It is hot.
We do everything we do here is customized to whatever shape you want. Basically, large format. We do also online stickers. So we have two companies. Real Simple Prints is more like the large format. And then the online is sticker.
Oh, that's the large format you're talking about?
Yeah, so we do, large format means that we can wrap vehicles, we can do signage.
Oh,
like okay. That. I just finished this one this morning. I have other machineries that, like for example, my friend has a CNC that cuts me the shape of acrylics and stuff like that, and we put it together here.
How long does something like this take to...
How long to produce it? Two, 3 business days.
Oh, shit.
We're pretty fast in our turnaround.
Gotcha.
Yeah, we're pretty fast in our turnaround. This one was ordered last Friday, and they're picking it up tonight. So that's why I was a little bit on the rush on this one. It's already done. They're gonna pick it up tonight at 6.
That's dope.
Well, this is the beast right here. She's the one that cuts all the holographics, all the stickers.
Woo.
This is where it gets all
yeah.
He was telling me about it, that you guys do that, that's cool. We definitely love to get into screen printing, man. Last year, we were about to buy automatic.
Mm-hmm. Automatic?
Not automatic. Because the thing about it is to us, is like, manual is cool, but the problem that I feel like I'm gonna have is that we want our production to be faster.
Yeah.
That's right? A lot of labor too.
And it gets a lot of labor. And we want to do his own brand with his own art, uh-huh. Right? So we don't want to outsource it. We want to definitely keep it in-house.
Yeah.
Do it in-house, have control over production.
Exactly, yeah.
You know, nobody has the artwork. And then on top of that, all the branding, we want to also be able to give it as a service because we're already in the service.
Yeah.
What's up, Randy? This is my brother, man, guys.
Oh, snap.
Yo, what's up, Randy? How's it going?
Hey, what's up, man?
Dude, hell yeah. This place is sick. Bro, your art is insane. Your work is dope.
Thanks, man. I appreciate that.
Dude, hell yeah.
For real.
I was telling them that back in the 90s, you were out bombing LA, you remember? But we got old.
That's what I'm saying.
Getting old now, man.
Nah, this is cool. The art, the sticker art, and then also the canvases are cool.
Thanks, man. I appreciate that, bro. Yeah.
All right,
man. It's nice meeting you, man.
Do yeah.
This is a big order that I'm doing right here. This is 15, almost 16,000 of these. Big order. So I get a lot of. Yeah, these are gonna be in sheets. These are gonna be labels that they're gonna be doing for a product. They have like, I don't know, like 15 different kind of flavors. This is Wawa. And we do all.
Oh,
it's a
lot. Okay.
So.
Is it on a bottle?
Yes, I'll show you the bottle. He does everything that has to do with graphics and designs and all that stuff.
Oh, that's cool. You guys.
Yeah.
Some shit like
that. Yeah. So we. He's in charge of all that. What I do basically here is production. I make it happen. He gives me all the artwork and that's
we'll definitely be interested in doing some stuff. We have there's ComplexCon. I don't know if you've heard of it. It's like a streetwear convention where a lot of brands. So we're doing it this year in November, Long Beach. So we want to.
It's like an IIS kind of status. You heard of it? IIS. It's like a convention where you get
you can buy the newer stuff coming out.
Yeah, when you go to go see the new, for example.
It's less of a trade show and more of like vending. So they have
so it's like a 2-day
Okay.
Like Champion has a booth where they do DIY, Chinatown Market or now Market.
And how you guys want to display like yourself on there? So you guys already
we have a 20 by 10 booth, and we're going to curate it. Half of it's going to be like Brenda's going to be doing DIY.
Yeah,
we're just
printing.
I'm working on finding somebody who does woodwork. If you know somebody, that'd be dope to
So we have to like build out like just the display for the clothes, and then also just like the whole booth. We might use it for a lot of printing though, because we need a lot of stuff printed.
Yeah, like
the walls
and that shit, something like that.
Stuff like that would be cool. Can I get an idea how much is something like that? Just like, you can give me like
an estimate. If you got it, yeah.
Something like that small?
Yeah, just was.
Something like that small? That one you're probably looking like about anywhere between $400 to $500 to the
screen.
And then
what about like the size of one in there?
That one's like $1,500.
It'd be good to have a sign like that to bring wherever we like to pop up.
I could do it in a full color. I could do a full color. If you see the one that I have. You could take, like you could actually put this on your boot.
Yeah, that's exactly. The plan.
It's like not heavy, bro. It's not heavy. It's like.
Oh shit, bro.
It's really. Bro, it's very light. Like, yeah. So, you know, if you need to adapt, we could probably adapt something to be able to clip it on your pole,
mm-hmm.
Right?
Yeah.
Or you could, we figure out how to be able to mount it with a frame.
Yeah.
That it's very solid, and then this will stand out, obviously, out there.
Hell yeah.
This is another level right here. Do you have your logo? Can I see your logo? Or what are you using for your...
We don't really have
a logo. It's just a name, honestly.
Yeah.
Something that we would want.
Yeah, if you guys put something together,
so you have
man.
A picture of the mural?
If you have something put together, man, I would love to do some stickers for you. That way you could kind of see.
Yeah.
Putting yourself in, man, slap them everywhere.
Yeah.
Slap them, man. That's how we do. Slap everything, bro. These were going to a gallery, and they were going to a gallery, but it got all suspended because of the COVID. And he's going to regain again, so he already got in contact. What's it called? The representative,
agent.
We're
just gonna like do a quick introduction. You can introduce yourself and just tell me a little bit about like Sticker LA and how long you guys been operating.
Oh, fantastic! Well, my name is Saul, and Sticker LA was actually made on 2020. It's just barely gonna have 1 year that we just started this business. With all the pandemic that happened, we had to find another resource and how to be able to do something different since everything went shut down. So Sticker LA came alive on last August. That's when we started.
Damn, and that's pretty soon.
Yeah, like, it's been
and
almost.
And did it boom from there? Like,
you know what? We struggled in the beginning just because we couldn't figure out how to be able to advertise ourselves online.
Uh-huh.
But once we figured that out, we started doing a lot of advertisement on Instagram, and then we started noticing obviously a big jump. So now it's been a year now, and we've seen the progressive of how much this has been growing to a certain point that we're like. We were able to buy more equipment
mm-hmm.
because the demands got higher and higher. So it's been good.
That's dope. Did you start out with like a smaller equipment? Because that's one thing with a lot of people when they want to start out a business, like, oh, I don't have the money for the equipment, or like, how do you start out?
Well, we started out way a long time because we have the first company that we actually had
uh-huh.
was a company. So the transition was pretty easy because we already had the equipment. But for those that want to try, there's out there smaller equipment, smaller options mm-hmm. to start off a business like this.
Mm-hmm.
So, you know, the having the right materials and having the right equipment will definitely help you grow your business and people like your product. So that's how we started. So it has worked for us.
So start small and then...
Yeah, absolutely. Well, I always believe that if you have the resource to go big, then go for it. Because the thing about it is that when you get into a business, you're looking to grow.
Mm-hmm.
So if you limit yourself because you don't have enough money, buy the biggest you can go from the beginning
for whatever you got, you know, mm-hmm. and then start growing, because you're not going to look behind, you're going to look forward. And once this starts going, it doesn't stop. And then, you know, if you had the money from the beginning, and then you're going to kind of say, hey, I shouldn't buy the bigger one. If you did have it. But if you don't, then just start with what you have and look for the smallest. There are small printers like Roland V20. Those are smaller printers that smaller footprint that you can start off from. If I didn't have this equipment from my other company, then I would have probably started there.
Gotcha. It's cool seeing you're like killing it, like, and you guys also reached out, so we had to come out and check it out for ourselves. So looking forward to doing business together though too, like in the future. I have one last question. Okay, this is something a lot of like small businesses, I know like small businesses, like, how many hours do you like work a day?
Oh, shit. Honestly, my average rate of hours that I work, it goes anywhere from 10 hours minimum. 10
hours, uh-huh.
And they could go all the way to like 14, 15 hours sometimes. Depends on the demand of you, what you're doing.
Uh-huh.
When you're a small business, you gotta limit yourself with employees. Because you're trying to build your company. So those are the sacrifices that a lot of people don't understand, how much difficult. You will work more. And at the end, you figure, man, I'm working so much more and not looking the same kind of income that I thought I was going to make. But when you stick to it and it starts growing, then you start seeing that. It
pays off.
And it pays off, man.
Yeah.
It pays off. You got to be committed for this. If you're not someone that you commit, if you can't commit to this, you're going to fail.
Well, thank you, man.
Absolutely, my man. Thank you, guys. Thank you so much for coming back. Oh, yeah. Man. Absolutely.
Get off my shot, dog. Come on.
In the beginning, our thoughts in the beginning of any business that you don't understand it yet. You're looking for a way to how to expose yourself, but mm-hmm. it comes to a point that it's better to let them come to you than you go put out. So
and let the quality speak
for itself.
Exactly.
So, two reasons why you're here. There's only two reasons why people come to our shop. One of them is because you found us either through some kind of social media, some kind of website, some kind of somewhere.
Mm-hmm.
And the other one is because somebody told you about us. Those are the only two reasons why you were there. But it ain't like somebody just walked, you can come in. Like,
yeah.
I don't take walk-ins, I take appointments.
Gotcha.
So the only thing about that makes us more like exclusive in a way.
Mm-hmm.
And what that guarantees us is that if you're here, it's because you're most likely going to spend some money. It's because you actually are interested in something that we do.
Mm-hmm.
Rather
than
just
kind of
take your time.
Mm-hmm.
I used to work in another print shop. I worked there for 1 year. And I noticed that front doors is a waste of time.
Because
people come in and ask questions. And they take a lot of time from you while you could have been doing production on something.
Mm-hmm.
Or you could have made another call and get another potential client.
Yeah.
Rather than having somebody say, so how do you do the banners, or how much would this be?
Window shopping.
Exactly. So I noticed that, and we noticed that with my brother, because we used to work there together. And it's just, you know, somebody walks in and they're just going to want to ask a bunch of questions of what you do, what it's all about. And then they tell you at the end, okay, well, I'll take you in mind, and I'm going to talk to this person and I'll get back to you. And an hour, 2 hours of your time just went to waste.
Yeah. Dude, it's so important. Like, this is something I think about too sometimes. Like, how, even like if you're in work mode and someone's like, hey, what do you do with this? Like, or like asking you a question and then you leave that work mode, it takes you probably another hour to get back.
When you're in the zone.
Yeah, exactly.
When you're in the zone.
Like,
when you're in the zone and you're like focused, you're on there, you know? Mm-hmm. When I get you, man. Like, I come in. We average about 50 orders, sometimes 60 orders of stickers.
A day.
Damn,
that's...
Okay, and that takes, so over all night, I leave my printers printing.
Mm-hmm. Oh, shit, smart.
All night. That's... Come in the morning, we laminate it.
Got it.
After lamination, bam, hop on the plotter and start cutting those suckers on there. I have a cutoff time at 5 o'clock. The post office closed. Mm-hmm. I need to take these suckers out there and drop it off. Why? Because people are always calling and asking, hey, what's the status of my order?
Updates. Customer service.
And it's just, you know, we produce, when we started, the first 2 months, we only had like probably like 15 orders throughout the month.
Mm-hmm.
And that was really bad. I was like, dude, this ain't gonna make it. You know, 15 orders, that ain't nothing. And the average order is only like $50 to like $60. Mm-hmm. Kind of, you know, we're not gonna be able to make it. Then we Randy figured out how to advertise on Instagram. Man, on November of last year, he put a special on there and an advertising one on there, mm-hmm, for Black Friday and Cyber Monday of last year. I wasn't ready for it. I'm not gonna lie. Let me tell you something. We went to doing 20, maybe 25 orders in a month, to 250 orders in 2 weeks.
Jeez, damn.
Okay, I wasn't ready with like my shipping label machine. I wasn't ready with all the shipping equipment. I wasn't ready. I didn't have nothing. And I was on my own here. Randy was over there. I told Randy, cut that damn thing out right now, because I didn't sleep for 3 weeks. Yeah. I worked every day, all day.
That's crazy.
To pull out those orders, and it was like just bananas. So then come December, we're like, all right, let's advertise again. But December is a slow mm-hmm, because only half of the month you're gonna be able to do sales. Mm-hmm. And then once that holiday comes, it's done. Then we started back in January, and then we started going. Honestly, from May to this month, we are pulling about almost 500 orders a month.
Mm. Damn, that's crazy.
And that's just really small stickers. So it's been amazing, the journey. Mm-hmm. But you said something very important that you're putting out there. How much are you willing to work?
Yeah, exactly.
How much hunger are you? How much are you going to be able to go through your pain? Standing on concrete for 10 hours, up and down. You know what it's like, Manuel, mm-hmm, right? Mm-hmm. Doing all that squeezing, your arms, shoulders, your knees, your feet. Dude, you got no life.
Dude, yeah. No, for real.
I got a wife, and I talked to her, and I said, hey, you know what? Help me out. Help me out right now. Because when you met me, I didn't have nothing. Mm. So I told her, hey, remember, when I proposed to you, it's like, you want to build the castle with me? Mm-hmm. This is the time.
Dude, that's dope.
You know what I mean? And that's one of the reasons why I married her, because she actually accepted that and believed on me when I didn't have nothing to offer. And now I joke around to her, now you're with me because of my money. Yeah, but still, you know, but it is true, man. It pays off when you put in the work. It pays off tremendously. And like, and we're excited. When I see that logo, man, I see this company. I visualize this company in a massive way. And I don't know, man. We got big dreams with this thing, man. We've seen the growth on this thing within 1 year. I can only imagine 10 years from now. That's retirement for me, man.
Bro, you're gonna take over the whole West Coast.
I purchased it and didn't use it because we didn't have the adapter. So when we got the adapter, we tried it on.
So it did come on and it's not turning on anymore?
Yeah, apparently.
Yeah, it would turn on and then it would shut off after like
5 minutes maybe.
Oh, shit.
Let me see the next one. Michael's gonna cream his pants. It look good, right? I was like, I looked up to the side, I was like, wait, what's that? It's like actual size.
I'm trying to print a full shirt.
Why are you trying to act like you just put it over your face? Like it's a costume. Yeah.
This is like full size.
That's like actual size, yeah. Life size portraits. Mmm.
Like not turning it at all is something different. So yeah, definitely. I'll let you guys take this. I don't think you even need to test this.
Thank you.
You guys are good to go. Get you guys out of here.
Do man, what he do? Please, please. Already know. All right. Presenting. Sheesh.
Oh snap.
Yes, sir. Damn. Yeah, straight out the oven. Yeah. Oh, this is nice.
Damn, that's came out really cool. I'm gonna like it better on this one.